Wisconsin, 1955, at a place called the Beacon, a restaurant in town. Dorothy was a farm girl, working as a waitress, put herself in college, up on the Oshkosh. Dick was a young man, looking for something to eat, man. She clasped him and smiled and knocked him off his feet. He was too shy, too tall, too hurt, but he couldn't stay away, so he came there to eat every single day. Stranger in the shadows, at the corner of the bar. He watched the two in silence. He must have been an angel, must have been an angel, must have been an angel, talked to Dick that day. He must have been an angel, must have been an angel, introduced him to Dorothy, and they were on their way. She said, that sounds lovely, but I'm kind of running late. Gotta catch the train to Oshkosh. He said, do you mind if I drive you? She said, well, I guess that would be okay. She didn't even know him, but she trusted him. The guy had in his eyes. She said, the train station's that way. He said, yeah, but Oshkosh is this way. That's a nice way for a drive. And a stranger in the shadows was never seen again. He did what he came to do, and he flew out on the wind. He must have been an angel, must have been an angel, must have been an angel. It must have been an angel, must have been an angel. Introduced him to Dorothy, and he was on his way. I said he must have been an angel, must have been an angel. He must have been an angel, I talked to Dick that day. Mom said he was an angel, must have been an angel. Introduced him to Dorothy, they were on their way. Maybe there should be another verse about eight kids and 14 grandchildren and some grandkids and some hard times and some good times. Nah. Stick with the love story. Everybody together just kind of clap along and say, must have been an angel.